Hey guys, today we are studying about principles of RPD design. So there are basically five basic principles which you can read from any textbooks. They are all mentioned. But today we are discussing about implying the mechanical principles on the biological tissues. Okay? So what are the mechanical principles? There are basically three mechanical principles: the lever action, the inclined plane effect, and the wheel and axle. The mechanical biomechanical considerations on which this RPD will work are following: direction, duration, frequency, and magnitude. The other two factors which we need to take in considerations are stresses and resistance. The three types of stresses are vertical, horizontal, and torsional. Vertically are further divided into displacing and dislodging forces. The resistance and support are provided by two types of RPDs: the tooth supported and the tooth and tissue supported. The tooth supported RPD resists the horizontal forces, and the tooth tissue supported resists the vertical and the torsional forces. Now we are going to discuss about the design considerations. So if any question is asked that write a design for cannabis class 1 situation, so what factors you need to take in mind before writing any answer? The design consideration basically is divided into 8 parts. First, based on the direct retainer. Second, the clasps which you will give to the RPD. Third, the indirect retention. Fourth, the major connectors. 5, the rests. 6, the denture base. 7, replacement of teeth. 8, the minor connectors. The area of our interest are the direct retainer, the clasp, and the major connectors. So starting with the direct retainers, what factors will decide or what configuration will decide what kind of direct retainers will be able to give? So direct retainers can be selected on the basis of three configurations. The first is the quadrilateral configuration. This configuration is basically seen in Kennedy's class 3 situations. Alright. So what is a quadrilateral configuration? In Kennedy's class 3, as we know, that there is an area bounded anteriorly and posteriorly by natural teeth. So in this, we'll give the direct retainers in such a fashion. So it will basically, a schematic diagram of that will be like this. This is the quadrilateral configuration. The direct retainers will be given in this fashion in a class 3 situation. Second, the tripod configuration. It is given in class 2 situations, Kennedy's class 2. What is a class 2 situation? It is a situation in which it is a unilaterally edentulous area bounded anteriorly by natural teeth. So in such a case, we'll give a direct retainer here, that will be here. One here and one here to balance out the leverage forces. So it will be basically something like this. So this is a tripod configuration. And the third we have is the bilateral configuration, which you can guess by now that will give in class 1 situations. And what does a class 1 situation mean? A class 1 situation is any situation in which there is posteriorly bilateral areas bounded anteriorly by natural remaining teeth. In this case, we'll give direct retainers here and here. Alright? So, it will be kind of this. These are the three direct retainer, the configurations on the basis of which we'll give the direct retainer. Then we have the clasps. Clasps are divided into cast circumferential clasps. Second, the bar type clasp. And third, the combination clasp. The cast circumferential clasps are never given in distal extension cases. So what will we give in the distal extension cases? That will be the combination clasp. The bar type clasp works on functions same like the reverse circlip clasp. So in distal extension cases, we can give reverse circlet clasp or the combination clasp, alright? And the third, the major point which will carve is the major connectors. So what kind of major connectors are given in which kind of classifications? So for Kennedy's class 1 situation, that is bilaterally edentulous area bounded anteriorly by natural teeth. We have got two options. Either we can give a closed horseshoe or a complete palate. In a class 2 situation, which we all know, it's similar to class 1, but it is unilateral. It is a unilateral edentulous area bounded anteriorly by natural remaining teeth. Here we can give either a closed horseshoe or a palatal strap. Alright, in class 3 situations, which is a unilateral edentulous area bounded anteriorly and posteriorly by natural remaining teeth, we can give a palatal strap or a palatal bar. And in class 4 situations, which is single but bilaterally edentulous areas bounded posteriorly by anterior teeth, we have got three options. First is the complete palate. Alright. Second is the horseshoe. And third is the closed horseshoe. Complete palate, the horseshoe, and the closed horseshoe. Thank you.